This speaker flouts himself with noteworthy achievements leading Philippines preventive health education and health reform advocate. Graduated among the top students of his class from University of Santo Tomas College of Medicine to the time he placed among the top notchers of the medical licensure exam to become most outstanding resident in internal medicine at the Manila Doctors Hospital and serve as the chief resident in senior year. Continued his fellowship in cardiology at the UPPGH Medical Center and likewise awarded as the most outstanding research fellow and also serve as the chief fellow in his senior year. Remained humble yet with tenacious disposition, he became one of the leading cardiologists in the Manila region. He was the medical director of Unilever Philippines from 1993 to 1995 and later as medical and regulatory affairs director to Pfizer Philippines from 1995 to 2010. Over the next two decades, his enterprise expanded beyond the practice of medicine. His portfolio came to cover, among all things, public service. He served as director of information, publication, and public affairs of the University of the Philippines, Manila, from June 2012 to October 2014. He was later elected Fellow of the American College of Physicians, 2014, and recognized as well by distinguished medical societies in Asia as a honorary Fellow of the Royal College of Malaysia in 2014 and Thailand in 2014. He has later elected President of the UST Medical Alumni Association for the years 2015 and 2016. But perhaps his greatest achievement remains to be Executive Order 595, the Health Education Reform Order, or HERO, an initiative he authored as chair of the Advocacy Committee of the Philippine College of Physicians in 2007, a 10,000-member strong organization of internal medicine specialists in the country, which he later headed as president from 2014 to 2015. His HERO program remains to be the largest Philippine-led advocacy on comprehensive health education and in disease prevention today. For leading and pioneering the passage of his significant executive order, he received a presidential citation from President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo in December 2007 for helping the government with its preventive health education advocacy. In 2012, he was the lead proponent of the civil society while working as a 1 peso consultant of the Department of Health on non-communicable disease in the passage of landmark 6th syntax reform law for tobacco and alcohol signed last December 2012 after languishing in Congress for 16 years. This pioneering mark promises to curb smoking and alcohol illness and is expected to continue an additional $200 billion in tax revenues for the government. He will probably go down in history as one of the most bemedaled Filipino physicians of his generation. He continued solid civic-spirited goals, being active in promoting social and community causes. From January 2016 to March 2019, he served the Philippine Health Board of Directors as an independent director, monetary board representative, and actively participated in various board committees from audit, risk management, benefit, investment, governance, and a host of others. Apart from his active participation in the different field health committees, he was a vital cog in the passage of universal health care law alongside the Department of Health and field health colleagues. He is a passionate leading proponent of the medical community and other stakeholders from the public and private sector in raising additional taxes for tobacco and alcohol to sustainably fund the landmark universal health care law recently signed by President Rodrigo R. Duterte. Furthermore, on January 8, 2020, the UST MAA, together with Tomas Awards Committee, once again recognized his contribution not only to the medical community, but to the public health as well, and granted him the 2020 Thomas Award in Public Health and Health-Related Issues. In light of recent events, the Philippine government has seen the need to utilize his expertise through the use of his valuable inputs in responding to the COVID-19 outbreak in the country. On April 1, 2020, he was tasked to serve as special advisor to the National Action Plan COVID-19, chief implementer whose main function is to provide medical expertise to the National Task Force on COVID-19. Indeed, a thick profile and accomplishment of his lifetime, he will forever be respected and remembered. Let us welcome Dr. Anthony C. Leachon.